Good morning, everybody.
Good morning, everybody.
It is Sunday. What is the date?
The 14th.
Sunday, August 14th. You're good.
I know.
And I'm coming to you from Burlington, Vermont.
Vernon, Connecticut.
Daughter.
Mother. Sue.
Chelsea. I forgot what came next. I didn't think they needed to know our names. Okay. So that's kind of our spiel. That's where we're coming to you from. This is episode 30 of the Legacy Knits podcast, if you can believe that. Yeah. Which is kind of cool because we are talking about a lot of, like a milestone thing today. So it's two milestones in one. As I think whoever, if you follow the podcast, you'll know that we just did our very first shop update in Etsy under Legacy Fiber Arts, which is our new business. And the response was overwhelming.
Overwhelmingly cool. Wow.
Yeah. Yeah. And we are so excited that all of you got so excited about it and that you all showed up. I know it was a really fun morning for the two of us. So hopefully it was as fun for you guys. And if you didn't get your hands on a skein, don't worry. Just don't worry because
Yeah, absolutely.
We're going to be doing another, the exact same shop update in two weeks. We don't have the exact date yet, but we will keep you apprised of that. But yes, yeah, so you will have another opportunity to get your hands on some Hocus Pocus yarn before the fall.
Yes. And probably after that one, we will probably move right into Christmas. It really depends. I may do I think we talked about this just... I don't know, like a pre-order, so many slots for the Hocus Pocus colors if people still want them. We've got to figure out.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, we'll figure out those details. Yeah.
First of all, it's got to get a lot cooler because I would literally die dying in the kitchen today.
Yes. Yes. Agreed. But so the big takeaway there is we wanted to thank everybody so much for your enthusiasm and your support and your love and for being as interested in this yarn as we were and still are. And just a big thank you. There are no words in the English dictionary to express how thankful we are and how grateful. And
there aren't. And I talked about this on Periscope, and it's really, really true. I think for both of us, we don't take it for granted. It's just, it really knocks my socks off. Literally, I don't take it for granted. It's an industry that has a lot of dyers, a lot of fantastic dyers, like unbelievable dyers. So to have that kind of response just was like, whoa, I didn't expect that. I mean, you just don't know. You don't know where it's going to go. Did I dye all that yarn and like maybe only a few people? You don't know. You don't know. So we do not take that for granted. And I think it's just said. Thank you. We're so excited. It just makes you want to get in there and like do a ton more. And
simply just to provide it to people that are so excited. Like every time I saw a message on Instagram that was like, oh, like, you know, I missed it by like a minute or this, that, and the other thing. I was like, all I wanted to do was be able to say like, I'll send you a skein. Don't worry.
It takes everything in me not to type that. Don't worry, private message me. And then as much as I want to be able to do that, it's just, you can only do so much. So you have to be, but it takes everything in me. Same thing. Like, oh, don't worry, I'll send you one next week. I don't even have the yarn to dye at this point.
Exactly. Yeah. So we're excited to start. Well, Mom's excited to start dyeing some more for you guys and giving you the opportunity to knit on it. I was going to say something else. I'm slowly working through Etsy messages and emails as well. So I'm hoping to have them all answered by the middle of this week. So if you don't hear back from me by Wednesday, because hopefully I'll post this today, shoot me another message because it either fell off my plate or flew under the radar, something. But don't hesitate to contact me a second time if you don't hear by Wednesday.
Yes. And my hope is we can provide all of you that want it with the yarn they want. That's my hope and my goal. I would really like to be able to do that. So we'll try our hardest.
So actually, a good segue. Do we want to start talking knitting?
Yes, because I had finished all of the dyeing that I could do, all the yarn I had, at the beginning of last week. So believe it or not, I got quite a bit of knitting done.
I can't wait to see it because I feel like we haven't talked knitting in so long. Like, this is actually like a catch-up session.
Yes. That makes me laugh thinking about it.
No.
No, I know. It's so hard because I feel like every time we get to talk, we end up talking business. And I'm like, I don't even know how her week was.
I know. So I feel like that'll be fun for the podcast going forward. Just like this is genuinely us catching up.
That's true.
All of our favorite people.
That is true. So should we do what we're working on?
We could do that because I think I just messed up mine. I'm going to have to put mine down now.
Darn it. You know what? I always thought when I watched podcasts, like, it would be so fun to podcast. I would sit there and knit and podcast. I really can't knit and podcast.
See, I can't. I definitely can if it's vanilla, but because I need to keep track of what row I'm on with this pattern, I really can't.
Yeah.
But I just want to be knitting on them so badly that yesterday, oh my gosh, Mom, yesterday, all day long, I don't think I put down my knitting needles once.
Oh, you're so lucky.
It was a great day.
What did I do? I feel like, you know what? I ended up floating. It is so unbearable here. It's unbelievable. And the water is still only like 82. I swear that thermometer hasn't changed all summer. So it's probably 88.
We'll check it in February and see what's then.
But yeah, so I ended up, I think I was so overwhelmed with, holy cow, what just happened in the morning that I don't even know what I did.
You were spinning.
I was spinning. I did. Well, you will see some things I did. A lot of mine, believe it or not, they're like a couple finished objects because they're minuscule. And then blanket talk. So a lot of mine is like finished but working on.
Yeah.
And then I have one finished object. I'm going to show that first.
Okay.
Right now, because you haven't seen it.
Okay.
I told my Periscope people, are you sitting down? I hope you're sitting down.
Can't wait to see this. Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh.
Unbelievable. And I say that because look at the finishing. Look at that fabric. Oh
my God.
And look at how it matches what's going on. And what an odd color this is. And this fabric.
Perfect.
Barb nailed it. Barb, I know you watch. You nailed it. I love you.
She's a goddess.
So much.
Yeah.
I forgot to bring the other thing over that she made. She made me a new dyeing apron.
Oh.
Which kills me to wear, but I'm wearing it. She was like, wear it to death, which is what I say to people with my knit goods. Wear it to death. I will make you another one. They're so perfect. They're so perfect.
Mom, that is beautiful.
Is it going to die? So this is, for those of you who don't know, this is Camden, my great nephew, who was christened 3.5 years ago.
Colton.
I keep calling him Camden. Thank you. Colton, who I do that all the time, who was christened 3.5 years ago, and he's getting this today on his brother Camden's christening, which I'm going to, and Camden is getting one that is 3/4 finished.
You know what? They're worth the wait.
They're worth the wait, and Colton, I think, because he's almost 4, knows what a Christmas stocking is. I cannot wait to see his face.
Yeah, that's the thing. Like, for Camden, like, to give them as a christening gift is great, but they don't really understand. I mean, obviously, they don't know.
They don't even know where they are.
Oh.
Oh, I cannot wait to give it to him.
It is gorgeous. Barb is a genius.
She is. And she's always like, oh, it's all about the stitching. I could stitch something beautiful if it is not finished. Hello, Justy.
You want to come say hi?
Say hi.
Hey.
How are you?
You brought me coffee?
Oh.
And a breakfast sandwich, an emergency snack, which we forgot to talk about.
Because I don't have one. Could you, what do you call that? But I don't like breakfast sandwiches.
No.
Maybe you could run to the farmer's market and get the blueberry bread and shoot it teleportingly, whatever you call that.
Yeah, like that.
I'm on it.
So, yeah, I mean, you can stitch a piece beyond belief. I've witnessed this in the frame shop when I owned a frame shop, and people would bring in the most gorgeous stitched pieces, but they wouldn't choose, you know, it's hard, it's very expensive, and they wouldn't choose that frame that I would have chosen to showcase the piece. So her finishing just showcases my work.
Beautiful. It's
just unbelievable. And the fabric, like, I keep looking at it. I'm going to miss it because I keep looking at it.
Did she pick that out for you?
She's always like, Sue, what do you want? I'm like, I don't even care. You do it. I totally trust her. There is no way she would do anything that isn't perfect. I know that in my heart.
Oh my gosh.
Hi, Barb. I love you.
Oh my God. That is so cool. It came out beautifully.
Beyond words.
That is so exciting.
Yeah. Anyways.
Well, that's an awesome finished object. I can show you a half. Well, no. I'll show you my finished object. So yesterday I finished my pseudo sock head hat, and I've gotten the question a lot of what pattern am I using for this, which is a tricky question to answer because I'm using the sock head. It's literally called the sock head hat pattern. It's a free Ravelry download. I forget who designed it, but I'll put the information on the screen for sure. But I modified it quite a bit. Like, I only did 2.5 inches of ribbing instead of 9, or however it calls for quite a bit.
I think it's 9 because I've made that.
And I don't know if I did the entire, like, if it's as long as it calls for either. But I followed the pattern for the decreases at the top, which I can show you guys.
Which, that's, oh, it's beautiful.
Ew.
Really, truly, that is the beauty of the sock head hat. You're just using their numbers. And then everything else, you just keep fitting it on your head. And a lot of people have done that. And people shouldn't be overwhelmed if they love it, but they don't love the 9-inch. Like, keep trying it on.
Mm-hmm. Exactly. So I can, and I added a few rows of green.
Oh, that's not in the yard. Honest to God, I had to go back and watch that. Quite often I have to go back and try to like speed through it to see what we talked about, what I showed. Cause I, being on an off schedule, I'm a little like, and when I watched that part, I was like, really, Sue?
That's okay. Because you know what? The green that I chose goes it really, like, I think there is some of it like within the speckling. So it's understandable.
Not, but that's okay. Because I think you said twice how you added it and you striped.
It's fine.
Whatever.
So I added the striping. So I just did, you know, one row of striping, one row of the body color, one row of striping, one row of the body color. I'm using my Eternity Ranch yarn that was sent to us, and I am obsessed with it. And I have, oh darn. Hey, Justin, would you want to, never mind. Would you want to throw me over that, the ball of yarn that goes with this? I'll show you guys how much yarn I have left over because it is significant.
You bet. You know what? Oh my gosh, fingerless mitts.
Yeah, like I have so many skeins of yarn from my projects this summer that are exactly this size that I need to figure out like something to do with them.
I feel like at work, because of where your desk is and because of how Vermonters don't know how to use air conditioning, I'm assuming they also don't know how to use heating, fingerless mitts might really come in handy for you.
Well, I agree, but I love the ones that you gave me. I feel like I'm going to live in those.
You are, but I also think the ones, oh my God, that's adorable. Right now, if I had to put that on my head, I would die. It's so hot.
That was us 3 days ago, so I do commiserate with you, but
adorable.
I'm debating, so what do you think? I'm thinking of making a really small yarn pom-pom to put at the top. Do you think it's too much with the slouch at the top?
No, I want you to buy a giant one and put it on top.
I could do that. Like my other one that I have? Yeah.
Yeah. I love those. I just think they're so gorgeous. And they're in right now, so why not? Because at some point, it's going to be like, look at that stupid giant pom-pom on that hat. Where right now, it is so not that way.
I can always take it off on that point.
That's the beauty of those. You can literally take them on and off. Yeah, I love it.
I like it.
I love it. That yarn is gorgeous.
The color's so fine. I could probably just do this. Aren't the colors so beautiful?
So beautiful.
Wish I had a band over here with me, but I'll put her information on the down bar because this yarn is great and so sturdy.
Well, and honestly, I'm not a real subtle pastel girl. I love that.
I'm getting there. I think I'm becoming a subtle pastel girl.
Well, and I think it's her combination of colors. It's beautiful. Just beautiful. It makes me want to go get that gorgeous skein I got from her and knit with it. I cannot wait to be done with the one thing I'm going to show you later or at some point. I just want to knit what I want to knit.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm at this point with this one giant project, which I love. It's just, I'm ready to be done with it.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm so close this week.
Right, right. Do you want to know what else I think I love so much about this, the colorway, is that it pairs the pale pastels with pops of neon.
Yeah. It's just a beautiful colorway.
Mm-hmm. That is what sings, like, I love it.
Yeah.
So that's my finished object. I knit this in using Magic Loop with size 1.5 needles with a 40-inch cord.
You're such a Magic Loop girl.
You know what? Like, with hats, it makes so much sense because you don't have to switch to DPNs.
You're right at the top. See, I would prefer to work on 16-inchers for a hat, but you're 100% right because I do 16-inch, then I have to make sure I have those in double point, and it is a pain. It's beautiful.
It was seamless. Like, I literally just, like, going, and it was done.
I haven't made a hat in probably years. One Christmas, I made gorgeous hats for all of the girls, you included, with the cable that, I think it was a cream one.
Yes, I still have it.
With the cables. It was a Twist Collective pattern, which I used to be a huge follower of Twist Collective, and I still love them, but it's off my radar. It's an online magazine that I love. And you buy per pattern, and the patterns are to die for. And having said this, I want to go back and look at the last. I probably haven't looked at it in a year again.
Go look.
That's really a sin. Really, really, because it's that gorgeous. Google it later.
I will.
And you can buy per pattern.
I love that.
Yeah. I honestly wish it came in hard copy because it's so beautiful. I would buy every single one of them. I know.
I'll have to look it up.
Yeah.
Do you want to see a hat pattern that I just downloaded from Andrea Mowry?
Not really. Of course I do.
Wheel. It's... I don't know if I do it justice with my screen and everything.
Gorgeous. Don't make me want to knit anything right now.
What's that?
Don't make me want to knit things. It's gorgeous.
I think I'm finally getting my rhythm back. Like, I went for a solid 2 months, like, being completely uninterested. And I think it's coming back full force.
Well, your life is starting to settle down. You're adapting to your changes, which you did so beautifully. But you do need a lot of space for that.
Yes.
A lot of space. And you're also went from not working for a while to, boom, not only working, but learning and... It's not just a job. It's a job.
Yeah. Yeah.
So exciting.
So, but yeah, that's a hat. That's one of my like pattern crushes for this week. I have a skein of yarn. It takes DK, and I have quite a few DK skeins over there. Anyway, that was such a tangent, but I have my eye on knitting that up.
Love it. Love it. I am just craving knitting on my stone cutter. And I think... I may even pull it out tonight. We'll see. We'll see. Okay. You want to see what I worked on this week? I don't think you've even seen these.
I'm sure I haven't.
Hold on. Look at it. I'm like, hold on. Don't look. I'm surprising you.
That's okay. I'm just eating away at my breakfast sandwich over here. Oh my gosh.
So this is for my Advent. I love it. And yes, the pattern is available in, I just feel I need a manservant over here.
He's our producer. He acts like he doesn't have a role in this.
Yeah, he's our producer. He's right. You're right. So the pattern is over on our, in our Ravelry group, Legacy Fiber Arts, whatever. Chelsea will write that. No?
Legacy Knits Nerds.
Oh, Legacy Knits Nerds. So the pattern for this is over there. So this one was done. This is, oh my gosh, Amanda the Yarn Enabler, Sock Monkey. Okay, this is ours. This is Sue Said So. So that's a new one. This is Mustache Yarn. I did finish this one. I love her yarn. I want to get some. This is Winnie. This is Patton's Croix. Gorgeous. This is, oh, Rock Strings Creations, which is one of my favorite. I have this sock. And then this is Little Mary.
Oh.
Yeah, that's Mary. So it's so funny. I just tuck in all the ends, and I'm going to get my clothesline and little, and I'm going to start it.
So how many was that?
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 with spellbook.
Oh! Oh my God, I love it.
8 with spellbook, and wait till you see this one. 9 with watermelon. I know. I so want to be making 2. I want you to have them all. Like, I want to make 2 at a time.
Well, don't.
I know, but it kills me. Oh. And so I used, for the minis, I used a mini for this because I had one. That's how much is left. I feel like it uses about, I think one of my Periscope people weighed it and it was 10 grams, or made one and it was 10 grams.
The sock.
The sock. So there's quite a bit left here.
Well, because how large are the Legacy Fiber Arts minis? 90?
3 yards.
3 yards. Okay, so that's not in grams, though.
No, and I should, I don't know. I'd have to look it up. I feel like half.
Mm-hmm.
I feel like 40-some yards is about it. Because isn't 10 grams around 40 yards? I think it is. I think I figured that out once. Don't know why I would retain that information, since I can't retain quite a bit. So anyway, oh my goodness.
They're so cute. So how many do you want total to finish that girl? What do you need? Like 20?
Well, I think it's 24. This is terrible that I don't know how many days.
Yeah, because does it include Christmas Day or is it just until Christmas Eve?
I feel like for Christmas Day, I should do a big one.
Yes. Like a real size sock?
Yeah, I got really motivated to do that this weekend because I wanted to see, or this week because I was curious to see how things were going to knit up. But now, mind you, this is so much smaller than a big sock.
Hmm.
But again, I love the mysterious way colors just work, and that can't be planned. And it's just, I think that's the funness, that's not even a word, of dyeing, to be honest with you, is you really don't know. It's like Andy with her sock blanks. She has no idea what those beautiful pictures are going to look like. So it's always a surprise, and generally a good surprise. I don't think I've ever gone, oh, I don't like that, when I've knit up a yarn that I had no clue. So, yeah.
Yeah, I love Sue Says So. I don't even have a skein of that. I'm going to need to buy one.
No, you won't need to buy one. I'm sure of that. But it's funny, when these are, I don't have any. Because at this point, everything I order needs to be sold at this point. Mm-hmm. Just because I can't get enough here. I'm really hoping at the end of this week, I'm going to order like a surplus, because I do need to get some. We should each have a skein of our colorways. But I think that's very common, because if someone wants it, I'm not going to hoard it. Like, here.
Love it. You have in my Legacy Fiber Art stash?
And those were my first ones, so those really are to be used.
Do you know what I love? So right now I'm working with, this is actually a good segue, because I'm working with, you can have one more look, just as I'm.
It's so fun.
So fun.
I still like look at them and go, how did I do that? Like, it is magical.
It's magical. Well, and you're very talented. Don't.
Well, I don't know about that. I think it's sheer luck, to be honest with you. Sheer luck.
But so I'm knitting. Okay. So my work in progress, I'm knitting my Mary socks, which I've been posting on Instagram. So anyone that follows me has seen pictures. Justin's eating chips over there, and the crinkling of the bag is like,
I can hear it.
You can?
I can.
Dump the chips out.
Sorry.
Is
Justin going to show his spell book?
I think he should.
I think he should.
He said he's going to let me show it.
Oh, Justy. I'm
so disappointed.
Whatever.
So, I have a half-finished object.
Oh, I love it.
It's really accurately portraying the pictures, too. And go ahead.
No, I was going to say it is. It's very, like, I'm seeing it exactly how I see it. Yeah.
And I love our Stellina base because it's not too much for me, for my personal taste. It's not too much, but it's also not so subtle that you can't tell that it's Stellina.
You can, that like shimmers.
I love it.
Yeah.
And we've talked about this before. Whatever kind of dyes you used were amazing. And the red is so vibrant that some of the Stellina is actually red.
I'm trying to think what I even used. That was a special combo.
Yeah. But so it makes it so much fun because it's like every once in a while you'll be knitting and you're like, oh, here comes the Stellina and it's red. So I don't know. And this was also one of the very first skeins of Mary that you dyed. So this could be a little bit different than what the end product ended up being.
That one, what I do notice in the ones that I'm shipping out, there's a little more white area. But other than that, like, and again, it depends. The Stellina grabs all the color. So there's not a lot of white in that one. Well, I shouldn't say that. It tends to grab it really quickly. But somehow, that's the beauty. I hope people feel that way of hand-dyed is every skein is different, but I use the same combination. But you just never know. I use the same combination. I have formulas. And then how they hit. So, and I love that about indie-dyed yarn.
Me too.
It looks so pretty.
Thank you. So I just started this yesterday, second sock, because I refuse to get second sock syndrome with these.
So good.
And so like you can see, I'm knitting it in Magic Loop, my size 1.5, Hiya Sharps. I'm knitting the Mina Phillips cobblestone sock pattern in her Beyond Vanilla Socks collection. It is so much fun and it flies. Have you knit?
I forgot which one I've knit. I've knit a couple of them. Which one did you say, Pebble?
I'm doing Cobblestone.
I don't think I've done that one yet. I did Pebble. I cannot wait for her next portion to come out. She's doing another hole. I hope I'm not lying. I'm sure of it.
Okay. I'm sure you're right, because I don't think that's something that you could fabricate.
No. It's just that I really believe sometimes I dream things up, and I think it's real. I'm 97.5% sure I'm right.
You know what? I am 99.9% sure you're right because it's Beyond Vanilla Socks Part 1.
Yes. Okay. Then I didn't make that up. Yes. And oh my gosh, Mina, if you guys haven't used Dad Just Shut the Pool, could you hear the difference? And he shut the, filter off. And it got really loud, like quiet.
Your sound is much clearer now. Isn't that crazy?
That is crazy because he's going to turn it back on because he's vacuuming. It's okay. So anyway, if you have not experienced a Mina pattern, you need to. Like her, that, oh, I'm so sorry. I don't know the name. The Brio shawl that we made.
Yeah. Well, it's squishy. What? No. Squishy?
I don't even know what language the real name. Anyways, it's probably her only Brio shawl. And you and I tested it. And her patterns are so unbelievably clear. Unbelievably clear. So, yeah, if you don't... And those sock ones, oh my... They're such a go-to pattern. They're fantastic. Mm-hmm. Anyway, I don't even need to say this because most people know this about Mina, but her pattern writing is phenomenal.
I've never seen anybody else write a pattern like she does.
I love it. It's
Mm-hmm. Like she goes as far to, so when she gives you the small, medium, large option for these socks, she gives you everything to do the fish or a short row heel in each one of those sizes. She is so detail oriented and is so descriptive in everything. It's,
yeah.
If you're a beginner, go to one of the Mina Phillips patterns.
Well, and especially if you're a newer sock knitter, oh my gosh. Mm-hmm. And that's the cool part because we're not, and we still love them. But for a new, it's the natural next place to go with your, from vanilla sock to Beyond Vanilla Sock. She nailed even the title. Darn it, Mina, you're perfect.
She's flawless.
Anyways, I love them.
Aren't they great? And I can't stop talking about them. I love the, it's kind of hard to see on camera, but there's the cobblestone pattern creates such a good texture. And I love that it's only on the front side of the sock and not all the way around. I mean, I would love it both ways, but I don't know. For me, it makes knitting the pattern a little more mentally manageable.
And I think that's why you're finding it so fast. I have to admit, I went all the way around with, I think I made the pebble one, and I wish it was close. And I think I used our yarn. I don't know where it is.
It's okay.
This house right now is just unmanageable. And by this house, I mean my office. People would be horrified. It's okay. It's how I function. I can't help it. Anyways, I did go all the way around with the pattern because that's just naturally how my brain works. Like I know I would have like gone, oh, I'll just knit the back. And then every 10 rows, I would have gone all the way around. Mm-hmm. So you know what, Sue, just go with it.
But that's the beauty of her patterns is that you can do it either way. You can customize it to fit your preference.
Exactly. All right. Should we go into the most ridiculous thing I worked on this week because it's so hot?
Yes. We have a plane flying by, so it might.
What's it? I hear it, but what is it?
A plane.
I forget you live like close to an airport. It's very. If you hadn't said that, I would have thought Justin was making a smoothie. Okay, so yes, even though it's 5,000 degrees, I brought out the cozy memory. The reason I did is I had the most lovely knitting day with two of my favorite knitting friends, and one of them has central air. So I worked on this. So check this one out. What I noticed, though, I've really lost my speed factor. I knit so few, and we knit all day.
Well, you were probably chatting, too, which...
We were chatting. We had lunch. Yeah, but I tend to still knit when we chat. I just think I've got to pick up my speed. So I think this is Allie of Savvy Skeins. I think that's one of hers. I have so many fantastic minis, so many to work on. This came in this package, and I cannot remember who gave this to me. I'm horrified, and I'm so sorry if you're watching, because I am enjoying this beyond enjoying.
Those are some beautiful yarns.
Well, and so far, so I believe this is from the Flying Kettle. I've never used them.
Either.
Then, let's see. Like I said, I didn't get a lot done. This, I believe, is Allie again, because she had sent me, I think I had purchased some from her a long time ago, and plus she had sent me some extras. I believe that's hers. Then, look at this. Look at this. It's huge.
Huge.
Oh. This is a new one. And this, I believe, is Yarn Ink, which I've never used.
Me neither. We have to start doing that more often, is using new yarns.
I have to get back to that. And I had said that's why I started dyeing, so I could buy all the indie yarns. So, because I do feel like we're missing out on Lolo Did It, oh. Yarn Ink, Cat's Kettle. Am I saying that right? I think so. And I'm so sorry because there's a million others of you out there that I'm just can't think of at the moment that I'm dying to try your yarns. And we've been lucky enough to try a lot of fantastic yarns, but there's so many more that I want to try. So
it's gorgeous, Mom.
Honest? Oh, so that one. That's it. I did like three or four in that day. That's not good.
I don't think that's, but your squares are also double the size of the traditional square. So like for me,
you would have six done.
Yeah. So it's a pretty. Yeah.
You're right. I forget. Like I have 60 stitches in mine. So it's a good size square. I always think like, oh, it's a big deal, but it does add up. And because when I do these, which I can't remember if I've shown this yet, this is my June block.
I love that. That is so perfect.
Yeah, so I have almost six sewn together as a full blanket. I just need to put the cream. I'll show that next week.
Yeah.
I say that. Oh, gosh. I'll try to show this next week because, so this is June, then July. Oh my gosh. Did I, like, stop me if I already did this? Seashore Karen, the best human on the planet of Earth. I know. She sent me these because on Periscope I was saying how I need, or I want to do July red, white, and blue. So I got this adorable little package in the mail. Seashore Sharon, heard you needed these.
He's the best of the best.
He's the best of the best. She know. Oh, Rhinebeck, I cannot wait to see her.
No. I feel like we are so lucky to be able to say she is one of our friends.
She was one of the first people that reached out to us. And that was because we were brand new. I don't even know how she found us. Brand new. And she sent us a giant package. Just like because she's the best. The best.
Incredible.
That's that.
I love that. And for anybody that has questions about Mom's Cozy Memory Blanket or I'm doing the smaller squares, any questions like that, we do have a whole post on our Ravelry group that will give you all of the details of how we're knitting it, what needles we're using, what kind of yarn, etc. So head over there if you want to know those details.
The main thing is number of stitches and the pattern we use. And it's all over there because we all use different numbers.
And even weights of yarn. Like I know you and I both do fingering weight only, but there's definitely some people that do DK. But for us, for what we do, it's fingering yarn.
Fingering. I feel like there's even some people that have included DK in with their fingering.
Yeah, I think that's probably a thing.
Yeah, I feel like it's one of those go with the flow. I think that's why I was enjoying it so much that day. I felt really guilty bringing it with me, which is ridiculous.
Why?
Because I really, okay, so we'll go right into, I really, really, really need to finish. This is a work in progress for the Afghan.
I love that square. Excuse me.
Of this one. So loving Lara. I wish I could say her name correctly.
I had a dream last night that we were like, a bunch of the knitters were hanging out. Then I went to say her name and I said it incorrectly and I felt so badly. So random.
I know. That is so funny because she could probably care less. But anyways, the Fawn Knits, we love. This was a bag that I won from her. It looks even more beautiful on screen. It's her felted wool, which I love being a rug hooker. I love this. It's perfect for this Afghan. It fits the book, which I should show. And I've showed it a million times, but people always want to know what book I'm using. So they could screenshot. This is available on Amazon. A lot of my Periscope people have gone right over and bought it because everybody should own this book, whether you make the Afghan or not, because it's all about the stitch patterns.
Yeah.
You could incorporate these in so many different things. So it's a Leisure Arts. I'm trying to look at the number on it. Oh, I thought usually they numbered their books. Number 932.
Oh, sorry, what?
Number 932, Leisure Arts. Sampler Afghans. I love this book. This is probably the sixth or seventh one I've made.
Mm-hmm.
Crazy. I should be doing them in my sleep. And honestly, I totally enjoy them. I really do. Like, I look forward to, I had the gray one going. That was another gift. I've put it aside. I cannot finish it and I cannot put that pressure on myself. So it's put aside. Not to say it's never going to get finished because I thoroughly enjoy this knit. It's just not when I have to, like, I'm on a strict deadline right now. I think I have 3 weeks left. I think we're getting down to three.
What's the date? The 13th?
10th. Oh, yeah. 4 more weeks.
You got it.
From yesterday. So this is another one. And honestly, it doesn't have to, you know, a wedding gift. I have a year. Think of those poor stockings that I'm on a year in. She's getting them this Christmas. They're done. I just got to put the charms on and then get them over to Barb. So this is another one. So after I finish these two, I have 3 more to go. So now, this is the cool part, is I started sewing them together.
Ooh. Oh. Go ahead.
I'm just sick to death of these That's part of finishing projects for me. It cleans my office. Because, mm-hmm. Like, this stocking is now finally gone, and this will be finally in a box. And that's what I need right now. That's how I clean. I finish. So that's how I clean. Okay, so This, it's really, really, really pretty. This is not a finished row.
Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh. This is getting me so excited to pull mine out of storage for this winter and fall. Oh my gosh.
I don't think they watch. We're not even, in case they do. Okay, hold on.
So for anybody that doesn't know them, my cousin's soon-to-be husband is a huge fisherman. So that's why that the anchor and everything is so perfect.
So I have all but one row sewn together.
I love that one.
I do too. I feel like I do the same ones over and over. They keep falling on the ground. Wait, which one? Oh. So I have 3 3/4 rows sewn together. And honestly, I can do a block a day.
Mm-hmm.
They work up so fast. A, 9 times out of 10, you've memorized the pattern because they're very memorizable. Even the ones that don't look like they are, they are. And okay, this isn't done yet. Even this one, look how complicated that looks. It's not. This one is a labor of love because everyone needs this in their afghan, but it takes triple the amount of time because each bobble is worked 3 rows. So not the whole row, just the bobble. You go back and forth, back and forth. And then this one. I love them all. It is so unbelievably hot having this on my body right now.
Put that down. And you're using worsted weight yarn?
I am using, I want to show you because I think it's easier to remember something when you see it. Dad's cleaning the pool. Can you hear all that noise?
It's okay.
It's overflowing. The storms here last night were, poor Isabel was freaking out. That's how bad they were.
Aww.
Lightning filling the room. It was so loud. Okay, so I'm using Knit Picks Brava. And it's 100% acrylic. I've talked about this before. I was so nervous ordering it. Like, oh, I'm not an acrylic fan, even though there's a place for it. I use it for other things. But this also was a special gift. And yet, like your afghan, I made you the same one. And it's a $200 afghan. Hmm. But I also got that on sale.
Mm-hmm.
But you just can't do that you can't. So I was like, oh, after I ordered it, I was like, well, if I don't like it, I won't use it. It was maybe $65 for the whole afghan. I would have used this for yours if I knew about it. I love it.
You would never, ever, ever think that it was 100% acrylic because I honestly plan on using Brava worsted for at least 3 of my future projects. That's how soft it is.
Yeah, I love it. I don't feel it has that plastic feel. Now, I've used acrylics that feel like plastic. I've seen acrylics that feel like plastic. I do not like it. I'm telling you, for this afghan, for any afghan, this is going to be my go-to. Go ahead.
I was going to say, I even think, like, for me, I'm going to make shawls out of that. Like, it is so soft that I'm looking forward to having it wrapped around my neck and, like, touching my face. You would have no idea it was 100% acrylic.
Not at all. Not at all. And it's washable. And I am so pleased with it because there's nothing worse than putting all, because I do believe when you put this much time into something, the material is very important that you use as far as enjoying the knit. That was my biggest fear. What if I don't enjoy working with it? Because you need to when it's this big. So anyways, I can't say enough. I've talked about it before. Beyond reasonably priced. I really want to say, I ordered 20 skeins, so whatever that is. And 20 skeins, I will have extra, not as much of the cream as I thought. Either that or I've lost a few, which could happen. They could be scattered about here. but 20 skeins is the safe number because some blocks take more than others because there's like the bobbles or, you know, some take really a half and the other take a whole. So I'm so excited about giving this.
Mm-hmm.
And it's not even that I'm not enjoying the knit. I just want to be done with it. I don't want to work on it.
It's a long-term project. And I think almost every knitter feels that way about long-term projects, where you start off and you love it, love it, love it, and you still love it. But like you're saying, you're just, by the end, you just want that final product to be there.
And I want the pressure off. If the wedding was, but see, if the wedding was in 6 months,
you'd wait.
I would. That's my mentality or whatever you call that. Mm-hmm. But I'm feeling really good. Yesterday I thought I'm sewing it together. It was 100,000 degrees. But I'm also sewing in strips. I'm not going to now put the strips together because I can't have that on my body right now.
Nope.
But, and then all I have to do is crochet around. I wish I could remember. I'm going to have to look at yours. You're going to have to, we'll do FaceTime so I can remember your edging because I just make it up usually. I don't know.
Well, so, yeah. Coming out beautifully. She is going to be so excited to get that.
She's good. They're both going to love it. I know that. And that warms my heart. And it's like, I'm so excited for that reason. Yeah, it's just, it's a great gift. If you have special people, and honestly, it's reasonable. And if you plan ahead enough, really, truly, it's not a huge project. It's really not. Now, I could make that a lot bigger. I do 20 squares.
Mm-hmm.
You could do it bigger, but I'm not going to.
No, the size you do is perfect, I think. It's perfect to like, curl up under in the middle of the winter or in the fall while you're watching a movie. Like it's just the perfect couch size. Like it's definitely not a comforter by any means or like a bedspread.
No. The other thing, a lot of people, the questions, I'll answer this because I feel like people will have it. It's 100% acrylic. So no, I'm not blocking it. It won't, you know, you just don't block it, but it blocks itself out. The weight of the Afghan, like if you notice, and probably next week I will have the full thing to show, which is kind of impossible on here, but I'll do my best.
Well, what we'll do is I'll have you take a really good picture of it and I'll insert it while we talk.
Yes. Because the weight will block it out. Mm-hmm. And then I might hang it. I might, you know what I mean? Just to keep it. I don't know. We'll see. But yeah, that's what I worked on.
I love that. And another good pointer about that book is we've spoken about your Madewell, cardigan and my Featherweight cardigan and how they're like very much the vanilla sweater. If you're a new sweater knitter, and how you can customize them so well. And I think that book lends itself really well where if down the back, you want to have a beautiful cable or some beautiful eyelet holes. Like that book is such a good resource to be able to get that and apply it to vanilla type patterns.
Absolutely. You're 100% right. 100% right.
I need to buy myself a copy of that book for that reason.
I feel like I should buy myself one to put aside because this is beat to death. I mean, really, 7 Afghans, notes everywhere. I don't even know what they mean. No idea, but I love it. So yeah, and the gray one is over there. It's there's a lot done on it. I don't know. We'll see what happens with that one. I would have loved to have given it as a gift. I just feel like it's unmanageable at this point. It's really hard, I have to say, now really working, you know, now that I'm working full time. Like I'm really even looking at Christmas, which I had said no Christmas knitting, but I always go back. There's no Christmas knitting this year. There's none. And I'm okay with that because I need knitting for myself. Like really, it's almost the end of the year. And the 2 sweaters, I had visions of tons of sweaters. Nope, the 2 will probably be it. So I have to definitely focus more on my free time, which I'm used to having a lot more free time. And I'm not complaining. I am thrilled because oh, I wish I could remember the quote I read this morning on Instagram about busyness, because I don't believe in busyness, like the busy culture. Like, I hate that and I don't promote it. So I'm not even saying like, oh, I'm so busy. I'm busy doing things I'm choosing to do. So it's that culture of I can't do that because I'm too busy. Like, I don't know why that rubs me so wrong. It's choices we all make.
Mm-hmm.
And I choose to do what I'm doing and I'm thoroughly enjoying it, but I have to adapt my thinking because truly I'm very spoiled in having lots of free time for myself. So now I decide carefully how I spend that free time because I'm dying to stitch. I'm missing it terribly. So that was just a complete tangent, but anyways, it is.
But I think that's a good point to make. I mean, it's such a shift in mentality because now it's like, as opposed to having your, let's say 8 hours from when you wake up to be able to knit on things that you choose. It's like, it's now pared down to 1 or 2 hours a day. And that's precious time. Like time is money. That is.
Absolutely. And I value time so much. Even when I had lots of it, I appreciate it. I'm grateful for it. But yeah, and now, but I have to say, I wake up in the morning so excited to be like, oh my gosh, I'm finally found something that I'm loving to do. And not finally, that doesn't sound right. It's just, we've made a choice to do something that we both are going to enjoy at some point, and it's super cool. Anyways, tangent. Holy cow. Woo.
What? So I have one project that I am dying to finish that okay. I want to show it so that I'm held accountable either this week or next week. And it's in my Yarn Cellar Studios elephant bag that I'm obsessed with. Everybody is obsessed with that has seen them.
Yeah. Well, it's the one that has my socks in. Oh, it's right here. Hold on.
Is it the...
And I can't tell you how many people come up to me and love this bag.
Mm-hmm. It's beautiful.
I feel so lucky to have it.
We are.
All my bags. Nancy was here yesterday looking at all the bags, and I was like, those were all gifts. Like, that just is overwhelming to me that this many people, like, wanted us. It's just so thrilling. I love it. Anyways, go on.
And we cherish all of them.
We do all of them because they're all, like, I was like, oh, this is my favorite. I'm like, no, wait, this is my favorite. Oh, you know what? I don't know which is my favorite. I love them all. Because, yeah. Honestly, because it's summer.
Oh, so good. Yeah.
Warms my heart because this is the epitome of summer for me. And I love the summer, minus right now where it's. And you know what? Honestly, if I had nowhere to go today, this is my favorite kind of day.
Because mm-hmm, you're sitting. Just,
yeah, it's just the fact that we're going to be out and about and it's really hot. And I like to, again, spoiled. On a hot day, I like to be in the pool. That is not okay.
Not okay.
Sorry.
I think a lot of people would share that sentiment.
I know. I just feel lucky enough to be able to do that. Oh, my gosh.
So, I...
Why are you showing this?
Because I'm dying to finish it. Look it. I stopped probably mid-row. 4 weeks ago, mid-row. What is wrong with me?
I want to make this so badly.
I am so close to being done, it hurts. So, I am bound and determined, like, this is going to be the thing that I knit on this week and next week.
Gonna be hot though, working on it, isn't it? Or no?
I don't care. I'm so dang determined to finish it.
And you know what? I desperately want to dye yarn for that. Because let's just say this, I do have some DK over there because we will go into the DK world at some point, not quite yet.
Mm-hmm.
So I have it over there that I could dye.
It's so an awesome knit. So this is, the Void Shawl, and I'm so bad at knowing the designer, but I'll post it on the screen. I started doing this with KT and Eric from Inside Number 2-3 and 6 Plus Twine for their knit-along, and per usual, I flopped miserably. But I am so excited that I joined because now I have 75% of this gorgeous shawl done, which I would not have done if they had not started that knit-along. So I am very grateful for that. But it's a great shawl. It looks so complicated. It's not. And it is something that I want in my wardrobe so badly that I just like, I want to have it off the needle so bad.
You have a great wardrobe.
I know. I feel like I really need to go through and like look at everything and kind of freshen them all up for the fall. And I'm excited.
You know what I wanted to tell you, not to tempt you? Nito has a sewing class tonight at 6, from 6 to 9. Sorry. I saw it on Instagram. I almost texted you immediately, but it was 6 o'clock in the morning.
6 to, oh, but you know what? 6 to 9, though. God, 9 o'clock, I'm in bed.
I know. I agree. On a Sunday night, that's a tough one, but boy, I would be tempted.
If it were on a Saturday, I would be there in a heartbeat.
I know. Nito is one of her local yarn shops, which is a terrific sewing, knitting. You are so lucky. You have two that I've experienced fantastic yarn shops up there. And I feel like there's more, but you have two. You have unbelievable ones. And Kelly, hi Kelly, of, I always want to call her Mustache Yarn. And I know it's not Must Love Yarn. Is that right?
Mm-hmm.
Must Love Yarn, the local Shelburne yarn shop. She's on my Periscope every day.
Wait, well, and you want to know what I thought you were going to say? Is she scored some of our yarn during the update? And I was so excited that she did.
Oh, you know what? I haven't even looked at everyone that did. I have to do that still. Oh, I am so glad she did. I wonder what she got.
I think she said, but I need to go in there and visit them soon because it's been a while.
Yeah, you're so lucky to have those two great shops. So anyways.
So I don't know where we're, anyway, so this is my Voyage doll. And I'm using marbles, interchangeables, and I love them. I'm obsessed with them. I think they're a great option. We've spoke about this in the past. It goes from a US 7, I think, to a US 9 for the garter stitch border. Hang on.
That's going to fly.
Oh, it goes from a 7 to an 8. So, see, I have the interchangeable tips right here, ready to switch them right out.
So cool.
Yeah, I've experienced no issues.
No.
I am so tempted to buy a set. Not even buy a set, but I will continue to buy tips and cords for these because they're awesome.
Yeah, it's great. You're so lucky you have that availability. Mm-hmm. You really are. Speaking of Cal's, we don't know what it's going to be, but we are going to have one soon. I know we talked about, I don't remember what we talked about, but we will get our act together and have I forgot what it was even for, but we'll figure it out. We'll have one soon because it is going to be time.
You know what? We'll talk about that this week and we'll give details next week.
Yes. That and we'll talk about the next thing later because I'm not sure what we're doing. Anyways, again, we'll bleep, 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 bleep this part out.
That was so fun to do with the last episode because we were so not on our game. And I was just like, we're just fast forwarding.
We were so, even this morning, I'm thinking we haven't done this in so long. Like, oh my gosh. But today feels more in our game. We are not used to it. It was so nice that Grandma was there, but we're not used to having an audience kind of thing. And I think that can affect, like, I know if Dad or Jacob were standing behind me right now, it's harder for me to focus.
Because it's like they're sitting in your brain a little bit. It's like they're there.
Yeah. So, anyways, do you have any more to show knitting? Because I have something that arrived yesterday at my doorstep that is you haven't seen and it's unbelievable.
I don't. The only thing I want to share is an upcoming what's going to be on my needles because I'm really excited about it and I kind of want opinions. So I'll post about it on Instagram too. I want to cast on Party on My Needles by Hohi Locatelli so badly. And I'll tell you who inspired me. Danny. And Molly, the fact that they are doing a knit along together, one, I'm obsessed. I love it.
How do you know that?
Don't you watch Homespun House said it on her latest episode. It's not a knit along. It's they're just doing like a two person like.
Yeah, and join us if you want.
Yeah.
Yeah. I'm like, boy, I thought I would have remembered that. Danny, if you're out there, I miss you.
She just posted.
Did she post a?
I think so.
Really?
I just got an update last night about her. I'll check for you right now because everybody should know that if they don't.
Everybody should because I run when Danny puts up a video.
Let me see. Where are we? I swore she just... Yeah. One day ago.
I'm so excited. Oh, and her mom is there. I love when her mom... Can you imagine if they lived close? We could have lunch with her and her mom. Danny.
That would be amazing.
I had a dream once about Danny, how weird is that, that we were at a fiber festival and she was there and it was at Northeast School. And I'm like, Chels, Danny's here. And we're like trying to like find her and we didn't know what to do.
Sounds like us.
Tangent, sorry, but yes. Can you imagine having lunch with her and her mom? I love, love, love how they interact. I just think they're so amazing together. I love them.
They are. They're great. I know. I'm so excited to watch her latest episode.
I can't wait. Okay, go on.
But so they're both knitting a Party on My Needles, and I don't know if it's their color choices or just them being them, but I want to have this on my needles so badly that I can't contain myself.
Do you know what yarn you're using?
So this is where I want to have a little bit of an informal poll because I have two different combinations that I'm debating between. Combination one.
Oh my gosh. I wish I, oh my gosh. What is that? What is that one? What is the solid?
This. In her succulent colorway.
Of course, the last one that she had.
Yep.
Oh, that combined with Connie's. Oh my gosh. Now is Connie's is softer than I'm used to. That's the one that we each got one, huh?
Hmm.
Oh my God. Connie is brilliant. I will just say that if you haven't used her yarn, go get it right now. I don't know what you're looking for. Oh, I know. I have that on mine. Again, it's way over there.
So, this is combination one, and this was when I was saying, like, I think I might be turning into a little bit of a pale pastel girl because, again, I think I'm inspired by Molly and Danny a little bit, a lot of it.
I think it speaks to how you like everything because you go from brilliant to that. You just like color.
Oh. Option number two.
Oh my gosh. Oh my God. And is that Volantine again?
Yep.
Is so, this what you went down in New Jersey?
Yeah.
I don't even remember what I have over there.
Yeah. I almost caked this up for a project a few months ago, and then I decided not to use it for that project because I didn't think it would do the skein of yarn justice. So this is again, Volantine. If you don't know who she is,
you're living under a rock. That was not nice. No, you really are living under. Oh, it's the hot chocolate.
Mm-hmm. So that with Republic of Wool.
I can't wait. I have Republic of Wool over there too.
No, I think I gave it.
Hey, yes. Oh my. I think that is gorgeous. You know me. I'm a high contrast girl. I think that's why I'm drawn to that one. I love high contrast.
Mm-hmm. Yep. Well, and that's why I want to take the poll. I'm curious to see what people think would lend itself better to that pattern.
I know the pattern because everyone's knitting it, mm-hmm. and I can't remember what it looks like.
It's what's that?
You have a picture? I'm sorry I keep looking over there because I'm so afraid I'm going to run out of power, but we're still safe.
Okay, good.
Although, I've got to get to a christening.
I know. We're going to finish up. We'll do this, and then we'll do your package, and then we'll do a quick goodbye.
That's good.
Okay, I'm just going to show you a picture of Party on My Needle so that you have an idea. And then, just quickly, I didn't show this. It's the Love Dust colorway from her.
You are making me, it is all week I've been like drawn to my stash pile, which I have unbelievable yarn over there. I haven't allowed myself to go over because all I want to do is cast on a million pairs of socks. It's,
yep.
And if I make those jelly roll socks soon, I'm going to have to kill someone.
Don't they look so fun?
I'm pretty sure I want to use our yarns with the orange. So they're very Halloween-y. That's the only reason is because I want them to be Halloween-y.
I think that's awesome. Hang on. I'm trying to find. I'm sorry. That's a little bit of a lag. This is a good idea. So this is Tracy's that she knit for it.
Oh, I love the high contrast. So there's not a lot of the second color, really. Or is there that I'm not seeing?
Mm-hmm. Not really.
Wow. You hate to use a whole skein, though.
No.
Hmm.
I'm torn.
Okay, do you have any other options?
No, just those two. So it's...
Honestly, I think the one with the hot chocolate will really accentuate the pattern more. I'm afraid the lighter Volantine color is... Well, I don't know. I could be wrong.
I think it just all depends on the look. I'm tending to lean this way a little bit more too, but like you said, I hate to only use.
However, if you're using so little, I feel like you could use it as an accent, or even I feel like you'll be able to get a pair of socks, like a shorty.
Okay.
Let's just say it. Matching socks would be pretty awesome.
I'm just so excited about knitting.
I am too, and it's killing me. Like, really, truly, I don't know how people go all weekend long.
Without knitting?
without having downtime.
Oh, it's, yeah.
It's because I really need it. Mm-hmm. Like, they honestly, all I'm thinking about is when I get home and I want to settle in to just, I am such a homebody one and a, well, the introvert piece of me needs so much time. And it's scary. The older I get, the more, we were just having this conversation. I was having it with Barb, as a matter of fact, of how that introvert side of me as I get older needs more and more time. Okay, you want to see what came in the mail?
Yes.
You're going to die. Okay, first of all, it's from Shanna. And Shanna, oh, darn it. What's Strings and More? Strings and More podcast. Oh, I almost forgot. So it's Shanna and Jamie. And Shanna is a yarn dyer. She does lamb strings yarn. I love them together. Jamie is just starting to dye. I love their dynamics. They're just, and it's so funny because they're from Long Island, so they've got the Long Island accent, which I don't think they think they have. Girls, you've got it. That lovingly, not meanly. I love that about them. That's part of what I love about them. So Shanna texted me or instant messaged me on Instagram, like the most lovely comment of how she so enjoys us and wants to give us something. And it was just lovely. And then she sent us a lovely card, which I will share with you later. I just love them. I love them. So she was like, can I send you and Chelsea something? I was like, no.
Absolutely not.
Absolutely not. We do not want anything. Stop. But of course, I was like, oh my gosh, we would be thrilled. So these are the extras she sent us. A beautiful bar of soap from a local soap maker. And then this is something that you have to have. I'm going to have you have it. She made it. It's something she does for fun.
Are you serious?
I'm serious. It screams you. So it is yours. I know. She was like, I do it for fun. I think I should know this because she's told me. I believe she works at AC Moore, like a big box, one of the big box stores. She's super creative. Her and Jamie went to art school together. I'll tell you all about their lives. Please. They went to art school together. They're just, I love their friendship. I love their friendship. They're so lucky to have each other.
Excited to get that.
So this is for you. And then the bar of soap, which is lavender, which she knows I love lavender probably because I tell the world. But then, okay, so she's a yarn dyer.
Oh, God.
I can't even believe. I don't even know. You're going to have to pick. I don't even think. Hold on. Like, look at that colorway.
My gosh.
It's taking everything in me not to cast on. Wait till you see this one.
Wait, there's more?
What? One for me.
Oh, my God.
So she does a... Oh, shoot. It's like a raven... Okay, first of all, I'm going to show you her card so that you guys will have it. Shanna. I love that name.
Oh my gosh. Those are stunning.
I know. Gorgeous. Oh. So check out her shop, lambstrings.etsy.com.
Yeah, perfect.
But I want to say it's something about a raven collection. I'm sorry. Poe collection.
Poe?
Yes, Poe. Edgar Allan Poe. They're both from her Poe collection. So this is called Ode to Virginia. Look at that.
That is just ridiculously gorgeous.
And this is her, the black cat. Tra-la-la sock.
So did she pair? Ooh.
Sorry. These are paired together. Heels. For me, it's going to be heels, toes, and cuffs. No question. And then these are, and this is Annabelle Lee. This. I'm so glad you can see the colors because at first it just looked dark and then I looked at it and holy cow.
It is stunning.
Gorgeous. And then this is Cobblestone Way to go with it. Oh. Which is very subtle, tonal. That color's not showing up well, but the other one totally is. This color's a little blown out. It's just a little, like a value darker than you're seeing.
Yep.
You've got to pick because I am casting on.
You have to pick. I don't care either way. You pick because it got sent to 85.
I don't know. We'll, I don't know.
We'll decide.
Actually, I think Dad is sending out a package of mail. Darn it. Sorry. And then this may be in the package. Whichever one.
Okay.
So, oh my gosh, Shanna. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. I feel so privileged to have been sent those. We do.
Thank you. Oh my gosh. I'm so excited.
And honestly, when she said she was going to send it, I was so excited, but I hadn't really, I've only seen what she shows on her podcast. And I've loved it all, but it's different when you get it in person. And this, I opened the box yesterday. First of all, I'm like, who are we getting this from? I totally forgot she was sending it. It blew me away. And this was after, right after we did the update. And I was like, oh my gosh. Oh my gosh.
It's gorgeous.
It's gorgeous.
Oh my goodness.
Look what else came in the mail yesterday. I'm so happy because I always have to wait till it comes on. It's not available on Netflix. It's not available on Amazon Prime. And I've been in the stores lately going, I wish I could find that. And then I get lazy and I saw it came up on, okay, so for you guys, it came up on Amazon. It was like $4.60. And I have Amazon Prime, so it was really only $4.60. I'm pretty sure it was a Prime thing. Mm-hmm.
I am so excited for you. See, we have it, but it's not like a really good quality one. Like, I don't know where we got it from. So I think I might need to order that as well to have it on DVD. I
could have ordered two. What was I thinking?
Order it. Justin has Prime too.
Yeah. So anyways, I'm really getting ready for the fall mentally because this heat is making it difficult to do anything. Like, I woke up yesterday saying, I am going through this house. I could not wait to, like, deep vacuum, dust. I mean, that's really all it needs, minus my office. But I even wanted to get in here and get really organized to create some headspace for a busy dying week because I do need that headspace. And you can't.
It's too hot. I mean, you guys are dealing with, like, 100 degrees with, like, 100% humidity. Really, like, as bad as it can get.
It equaled 107 yesterday, Dad said. And for those of you who are like, why don't you have central air? Why don't you have air conditioning? We have air conditioning in the bedroom. We opted out for central air when we moved here. We found this house half built. And it was an option. We have the ductwork. And I wanted a pool. Because you guys were little. And it was like, if we have central air, I'm going to have three kids that want to be inside. And they need to be outside in the summer. And to me, summer is about being in a pool all the time.
Yeah. We were lucky enough to grow up with someone in the family always had a pool.
Well, and don't you remember, this brought back such good memories for me. It was like when we lived on Union Street, I would say, okay, at 1 o'clock, we'll all go out to the pool because you guys couldn't be in the pool alone. So all morning we would do our thing. And then at 1 o'clock, we were in the pool for the rest of the day.
Till
the sun went down. And that, like, those memories are my favorite. My favorite. It's like, so, you know, we don't have air conditioning. We opted for a pool instead. And I'm to this day glad we did. If we had central air, it would only be on weeks like now. For me, even living here now, it's like, I don't like air conditioning.
Mm-hmm. We've always been in open windows with the fans on type of a family.
We have. And I actually enjoy the heat, but this is pushing it. But it's also making me very ready for the fall, which I like. I don't like when fall comes and I'm not ready for it. I want more summer. So I'm okay.
Well, and it's good too, because where we live, I mean, in the Northeast, these types of days, you know, of course, there are the freak summers where they're always here. But we really only have, I would say, 7 to 10 of these days a summer.
And that was my thoughts when it came to air conditioning. Why do I want to spend all that money for maybe 10 days? And a pool we would use for, well, when you guys were little, a good solid 2.5, 3 months. So, but yeah, I'm ready for it to end. I start the air conditioner 2 hours before we go upstairs because it's that hot. And honestly, this is really, we're going on 2 to 3 weeks of not unbearable like this, but a lot.
Mm-hmm. Hot. Yeah.
Am I feeling like I need to be a weather forecaster right now? I'm not sure.
Because you are in a very warm area right now. Yeah.
And I have to close all the windows because we're leaving. in my office. The rest of the house, I go and mop up the floors. I don't care.
Yeah.
But my office, destruction would happen. Anyways, are you going to the lake today, I hope?
I don't know. So we're not dealing with anywhere near the type of heat that you guys are dealing with at this point. And it's a little bit cloudy. It's forecasted to rain. So we might. I have a few errands that I want to run. I also want to edit this podcast so I can get it up. Some like beginning of the week prep, grocery store, that kind of stuff. So if we have the time, we'll try and get in the water. But I don't know if that'll happen or not.
Sounds like a very fun day.
It will be, I think.
Very fun. All right, well, I have a christening to go to, which I'm really excited about. I haven't seen Camden since we saw him together at the shower.
He's already grown so much.
Huge. He has a huge head. He's so Jacob.
He's so cute.
He's adorable. And I get to see Colton, which I'm really excited about.
Mm-hmm.
So still want to steal him for a day, and my days are getting numbered. I got to figure that out.
Hmm.
So, yeah, that's where I'm going, and... it's a dying week.
Yep. Sounds good.
We're excited. Thank you all so much. Again, there aren't, like you said, there aren't enough thank yous.
Mm-hmm. Yes. Thank you.
And hopefully we'll be back next week. I have no idea what next weekend is bringing yet. I feel like it could be a free weekend.
Oh, mine's the exact opposite. We have a bunch of people coming up next weekend. So if we do a podcast, it'll be Monday, not Sunday, just so everybody.
Yeah, that's a good, I forgot you do have company. You have Allie coming. No. Is it Allie?
No, Liz, it's Liz, Jay, Ray, and Dylan.
Yes.
But we'll I'm chatting with Allie, and we're going to do like a November visit, I think.
Oh, that's a great visit. That's when I want to come next. I'm kind of sick of the heat of Vermont.
Yep, I don't blame you.
Yeah, and honestly, that's probably the next time we're going to get up there.
Mm-hmm.
I've been able to come up so much. It's been so much fun. But yeah, from here on in, we're getting pretty busy. Anyways, so we'll see you next week, hopefully. Fingers crossed. Again, summer, we'll do our best.
So yeah, that sounds great. We'll plan on next week. If we don't end up recording, we'll throw you guys out a post on Instagram and let you know when we do plan on doing it. But otherwise, enjoy your week. And thank you again. I will echo Mom's sentiment. Thank you for everybody that participated in our update. And to those of you who didn't get any, hold tight.
Hold tight. Good things come to those who wait. That's a hashtag.
Yes. Yes. I love it.
And also, the shipping is starting this week. So yarn will start going out into the world, that is going to be crazy.
Oh yeah. That actually reminds me. I would love to, and I actually didn't even run this past you, but I hope you don't mind me saying it.
This is what I was going to talk about when I said we'll talk about later, but it was only because you have it clearer in your head how you want to do it. So you go ahead and talk about it.
Are you talking about a hashtag?
Nope, never mind.
Okay. I was thinking, so when people start getting their yarn and casting on and knitting with our yarn, we would love to see it on Instagram, like, tag us, and we would love it if you'd use the hashtag Legacy Fiber Arts Yarn or Legacy Fiber Arts, either way, but just, you know, let us know that you're knitting it, and we would just love to see it out in the wild.
That's the fun part.
So what were you talking about, though?
That we would like to do some sort of, because our following is getting really big over on our new Instagram feed.
Oh, yes.
So, although we haven't really talked about it, but we are going to do something at a certain, we'll announce how many followers, and there will be a prize, and it will be some yarn.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
But we have,
oh. Yeah. So we don't know the exact number that we want to, but thank you for everybody that went over there as well. We are over 1,000 followers in less than a week. Holy guacamole.
Guacamole is a good one.
Yeah. So we are definitely going to be running a giveaway, like you said, Mom, and we will post the details of that under our Legacy Fiber Arts handle. So if you don't follow us there, make sure you head over, because you'll be able to know when we are going to be doing that giveaway and participate.
Yes. And a lot of people were having trouble finding the Instagram or the Etsy shop. And so the best way to get to it right now is through that link. Mm-hmm. That's the best, fastest and quickest kind of means the same thing, way to get there.
We're getting punchy.
It's Sunday. It's hot. I've got to go. I've got to get the pepperoni bread. I've got to pack the present.
Lots to do. And also, just to piggyback on what Mom said, I am going to put all of the links to the Legacy Fiber Arts stuff going forward in the down bar of each and every episode of our podcast. So you can also easily access it there.
Perfect. All right, girls.
Let's go. Thank you for coming and spending some time with us. We love, love, love spending time with you each and every week.
You guys are the bestest.
That's the best way to say it. Exactly what Mom just said. So enjoy your week. We'll see you next week. Needles up.
Needles up.